Hello, welcome to a new video of Appelboom.com. My name is Joost Appelboom and I would like to tell something in this video about the Opus 88 Coloro fountain pens. As always, if this video helps you, leave us a like, and if you're interested in these fine writing instruments, visit our store in Laren or order it online in our web store at Appelboom.com. We will talk later about the box the pen comes in, the features of the pen, the filling mechanism, the nib. We will also do a little comparison and give you some specs, but first we start with the history of the pen and where the name of the pen comes from. Opus 88 is a Taiwanese company, and the name Opus was chosen because the company tries to tell the pen enthusiasts that they are very good in using different materials to create pens. The number 88 is a reference to the year of the company was founded. For over 45 years, Opus 88 was manufacturing for other brands. They created the most outstanding writing instruments for famous fashion and pen brands. And then since 2016, the owner Michael Hasuk decided he was able to do it better and created his own writing instruments collection. The Coloro pen was the first model Opus 88 created under their own name. After the Coloro, the Picnic demonstrator pen and the Omer followed quickly. The Coloro is a traditional eyedropper filled fountain pen with a piston operated shutoff valve. But more about that later in the video. The Opus 88 Coloro pen comes in a black cardboard box which has a leather lookalike print on it. On the right top side of the box, the logo of Opus 88 is embossed, while on the left side you can find the founding year. The front of the box lid has a magnetic cloaking system. When you open the box, the pen lays in a foam inlay to prevent the pen to get any scratches or can move around in the box. Also, the gloss eyedropper and a small booklet with information about Opus 88 is inside the box. The Opus 88 Coloro is made of a combination of resin and ebonite. The barrel is semi-translucent, so you can see the filling mechanism and the ink level inside. While the cap is semi-translucent near the nib, you can see that through its nib window. The piston up end parts of the cap are made of ebonite. The ebonite parts feel a little bit rougher compared to the resin parts, and it also smells different, but it is hard to show you in a video like this. The metal parts of the pen, like the clip and the piston knob ring, are silver colored. The Opus 88 Coloro collection is offered in four different color combinations. As mentioned in the collection name, the Coloro is quite colorful. Opus 88 hoped to bring the clients a colorful feeling with this collection. I'm not sure if these are the four colors that we have to deal with, or that in the future there will become more colors available, but for now the collection is as follows. There is a blue version with the ebonite parts in cobalt blue and the resin in a more of a lighter blue. There is a red version which has a very bright red resin part of the pen and a more orange red ebonite. The third version is yellow. You almost need sunglasses for this edition because it's so shiny. The ebonite part is more of an old yellow, while the resin yellow really shines. The last version is the beige version. It has a blue resin body with the ebonite parts in tan color. The pen has flattened ends, like the famous Duofold model of Parker. The ends of the pen are not completely flat. There is a small dome on it. On the bottom of the cap, you can find the brand name Opus 88 engraved on the ebonite. The clip is shaped quite elegant and it is very sturdy. Please be careful with using this clip. It might bend or deformate when using it. The sides of the clip have a ribbed pattern, which is a nice touch. The cap twists off with 3.5 turns and it reveals a beautiful large grip section. The grip section is made of the same resin as the rest of the pen. The step down to the grip section from the barrel isn't that large, but the threads of the cap are quite sharp, so it is not comfortable to holding the pen near the threads. The Opus 88 Coloro has a silver colored stainless steel number 5 sized Yowo nib with the name of Opus 88 engraved on it. Below the name engraving of Opus 88, you can find the nib white. The nib is finely engraved with some endorsements. Most interesting part of the Coloro pen is the eyedropper filling mechanism. Because of this filling mechanism, the pen has an ink capacity of 2.14 milliliters. For reference, a standard international ink cartridge only takes 0.77 millimeters. So the Coloro takes 2.8 times more ink compared to a standard international ink cartridge. How does this eyedropper system work? Well, actually it is quite easy. First you unscrew the grip section of the barrel. You notice the O-ring on the grip section, which prevents the ink from leaking once the section is screwed back together. Please don't lose it. After that, you unscrew the knob on the end of the barrel of the pen, and then you pull the ebonite piston so it allows you to fill the barrel with ink using the included glass eyedropper or syringe or whatever you want to use. After that, you screw the section back on the barrel of the pen and slide the ebonite piston back in the barrel of the pen and screw the knob back in. The end of the ebonite piston has a rubber gasket, which seals the feed off from the barrel when fully depressed, which reduces the risk of leaking and burping. By unscrewing the knob and loosening the rod at the rear of the barrel, you open up the ink flow of the feed. Leave the shutter valve open during writing sessions to take advantage of the impressive ink capacity and get a wetter line. This eyedropper filling mechanism can normally be found on the more expensive and exclusive models. Actually, this is one of the most affordable models I know using this particular system. The Opus 88 Coloro has a total weight of 24 grams. The barrel alone weighs 13 grams, while the cap is 11 grams. Therefore, the pen is quite light, but heavier compared to the Opus 88 Picnic, for example. Here you find a comparison with some pens with a comparable size. From left to right, you see the Opus 88 Demonstrator, the Opus 88 Picnic, the Opus 88 Omar, the Opus 88 Coloro. Here we have the Visconti Rembrandt, the Lamy 2000 and the Pelican M205. Here you see the pens uncapped. And here you see the pens posted. This was our overview of the Opus 88 Coloro collection. If you're interested in the beautiful Opus 88 Coloro after watching this video, you're welcome to make your purchase in our web store. Let us know about your experience with this pen and share your thoughts and special moments using an Opus 88 in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe.